Whoa! Dude, it's a Viper motor in here. Oh, that's a restomod if I've ever seen one. That's cool.
That's pretty fucking sick.
Whoa! Sir, is this your ride?
Yeah.
That is phenomenal. That the Viper motor, eh? What year is that? What, Viper
motor? 2004 Viper engine.
2004 Viper engine?
Yeah.
Okay, that's awesome. How did you even get it in? Like get it in there and whatnot?
Only trouble was the transmission. The Viper transmission was a real bugger because
it has a Viper transmission in there.
Yeah, 6-speed Viper transmission.
Yeah.
So, we had to cut the transmission tunnel, open it up,
yeah,
weld the section in there.
Yeah.
All the front end had to be re-engineered because so we put a rack and pinion in with 2A1 suspension and everything.
Yeah.
But nice driving car. It's really nice to drive.
That's crazy. How long did it take you to build?
We started 10 years ago. We did kind of, we had it on the road after a couple years, but just been adding things. Not much we can do on it anymore. Just
yeah. Oh, so basically it's done, eh?
Yeah.
That's fair.
We like fixing them up. I actually like fixing them up more than driving them. I don't know if you've seen the 71 Mach 1 down there and grabber line.
Oh, yeah, okay.
I did that one. I just sold it to him in the spring.
Nice.
We kind of do one every year kind of thing. This one we've kept.
What year's the Charger? Like that?
It's a 72.
It's a 72.
Yeah.
And how'd you get this Charger?
We bought that in the States. It was just didn't have a motor or transmission. That's why we.
Oh, so already half the work was done.
Yeah.
Or a quarter of the work was done.
Well, you know what the hell? We'll just work on it from there. But well, it's a fun project.
Yeah.
There's only one of them, so.
Well, there's literally up there. The first thing that came to my mind was that's a restomod.
Yeah.
Because everyone, what's the typical one? 6-1.
Yeah.
I think that there's a Dakota up there with a 392.
Yep.
The white one.
Thanks.
But you don't see. This isn't the first that I've seen a Viper motor.
Right. Yeah.
Holy.
Yeah, they're not easy to come by, but.
Any work done to the Viper motor?
Tune.
Okay.
We got like different exhausts and stuff like that, but the tune, you put it onto the cartridge into the computer port there and drive it, and then you send it back.
Yeah.
After it really goes now.
Yeah. I bet it's good because it's electronic ignition, right? Rather than a carbureted one.
Yeah. Oh yeah, everything's it's like restomod. It's new stuff with. Like an old car. So, I mean, it drives really nice too with the rack and pinion and everything.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
Power steering and everything?
Yep.
Yeah, the whole thing.
Got the Wilwood brakes on
Wilwoods.
Forward disc brakes.
Yeah.
And then we put the, instead of using the vacuum, we didn't have much room in the engine compartment, so we put in this power boost.
Power like
from a
right.
Van,
yeah.
Brakes run from hydraulics.
Yeah. Oh, right. Okay.
So, really good brakes.
Yeah. What was the worst part of this build? Like, the absolute took the most time.
Again, like I said, trying to fit it in. I kept having to take it out and put it back in, take it out, put it back in.
Yeah.
To see where it doesn't fit, you know. Oh, yeah. I've got some problems there.
I guess you have to modify the drive shaft as well.
Oh, yeah. We had to get that made.
Yeah.
And, I mean, every piece on the car is either new or we really, you know. But, hey, fun project, you know, it's father and son thing. I painted it.
Is that the original purple? Or is that like Plum Crazy?
That's Plum Crazy, but it's from a 2010.
Okay.
The ones down there.
Right there, yeah.
Crazy Pearl.
Pearl.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
So, you know.
How long did it take you to paint?
The paint?
Yeah.
Oh, that paint.
That was easy one,
quick.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just getting it ready for paint that takes all the time.
Yeah. What's the rear end on it?
We put in a 373, but probably could have been a 350.
Yeah.
Because like 70 miles an hour, you're doing about 1,300 RPM on the highway.
Wow,
so it's almost idling.
100%.
But, So I don't know how fast it's geared to go, but
yeah.
The tires would probably blow up before you got the full speed.
No, exactly. How much horsepower do you think you're pumping around?
Well, stock is 505.
Mm-hmm.
So I think the guy tuning place said we're closer to 600 now.
There you go.
But and the torque is the same with the 10th cylinder. They get crazy torque.
But also, too, it's probably because it's a fairly heavy car, right?
No,
it's not?
200 pounds from the factory.
It's lighter than those things.
Yeah, oh,
geez. Hey?
This is my wife's car. It's like
nice.
A freaking 4,000 pounds,
right?
Those things.
I know.
Yeah. So much more electronics and all that crap. These are simple.
Yes.
And
yeah,
the engine actually weighs less than the original engine.
Really?
And there was a 400.
Yeah. Oh, right.
It's all aluminum V10.
Yeah.
So.
That's crazy. This is an awesome build.
Thanks.
This is great. Good job, sir.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah. You don't drive it in the winter, do you?
No.
No?
No, you can't even drive it in the rain. I got these drag radials.
Yeah.
And coming back from the Dream Cruise run one year, we almost killed the family.
Oh, shit.
Driving along, and all of a sudden, this freak rainstorm came out of nowhere.
Yeah.
It just picked up, and I was kind of going sideways at 70 miles an hour on I-75.
Yeah.
I just pushed in the clutch and let it slow down.
Yeah. And that's a manual, too.
Oh, yeah.
It's a manual.
Yeah.
And it's a different world. Manual is a different world, man.
Yeah, you start losing it, the first thing you do is push in that clutch.
Yeah.
Otherwise, the rear tires are working against you.
Yeah. Have you taken it to the track at all?
The drag strip?
Yeah.
No?
Technically, you don't need to, right?
Like I said, my son raced a guy out in Leamington on a closed road.
Yeah.
It was a Chevelle SS with a supercharged LS3.
Yeah.
And my son beat him by a bus. Actually, just taken off, he was a bus length ahead.
Well, the thing is, your setup from the motor, the transmission, and then the rear end is really like good top speed highway killer, right? Yeah.
Yeah, it really takes off from the light.
Yeah.
And the drag radials, they help too.
Yeah. Well, awesome. Thank you, sir. Appreciate
it. No problem. You have a good
one. You too. Take care. Awesome build. Viper at the freaking hood. We got bees everywhere.